Are you immersed in a sea of business advice and education, but not sure what to embark on first? Instead of adding to the ocean of information, we're here to help you navigate it like a pro. The Wayfinding Growth Podcast will help you take a deep dive into new actionable strategies, tools, and tactics to help you grow. So start charting a course for business growth as you explore a better way to grow further, faster, with your hosts, Remington Begg and George B. Thomas.
And can you believe it, Remington? We're actually on episode 2.
We made it.
It's crazy. It's absolutely crazy that we've made it to episode 2. No, I'm just kidding. You know, here's the thing. I'm still like, I'm coming off the fact that the Hubcast is no more. We did 172 episodes. We're starting a new voyage that is Wayfinding Growth. We've got a great guest today. But Remington, how are you doing this week? Because this is the week after I think we both lost our minds.
I think everyone's looking at me as if I'm in a drunken stupor, and I think it's just too much information still going through my brain. You know, I feel a lot better since we did that like detox of all of that information on that video we did last night. But yeah, I mean, HubSpot Partner Day was legit. And it's funny, I see people on Twitter going through the same thing in Europe right now. And yeah, I'm just glad that's over with in a really good way.
Everybody in Europe, we're praying for you because HubSpot Partner Day, it was crazy. 2 days of just information. Of course, we're going to bring some of that information to you in the later episodes of Wayfinding Growth, but let's go ahead and get into this, Remington. Today, we are going to be talking with a special guest, might I say, maybe the coolest man on the internet. Wait till you see his background. And it is the topic around something that is so important, which is video for sales teams. Look, everything that we talk about when it comes to Wayfinding Growth is about revenue. Money, money, money. Like, you got to make that money. This is video. This is sales teams. We are talking to the one, the only, Owen Video. Yes.
What's up, my man?
Look at
so
that.
Good to be here today with you guys. Wow, what an intro. Let me tell you, I've been called a lot of things on the internet. The coolest guy on the internet, I'll take it. I would rather that. I would rather be fun. I would rather be cool. I would rather be exciting than any of those other stuffy, you know, businessy words. In fact, that's why I left, you know, the corporate salary lifestyle. Number one is because I was escorted out by security. And number two, because I didn't fit in there. I didn't fit in there, you know, and doing video, talking about sales, which is, I mean, me at my core, I'm a salesman and I love sales. I believe sales is what helps to get someone to a new place in their life. You know, people's, their own worst enemy is themselves, right? And they, well, I need to gather all the details and the documents and that sort of thing. And a salesperson helps them get from bad car that breaks down to new car that never breaks down. A salesperson gets them from throwing money away in rent to getting them into their first home. And so it's always a pleasure to talk about these topics.
Yeah, true that. I want to do a little bit of housekeeping just so everybody knows. Talking to Owen Video, the Video Spot, thevideospot.net is where you can probably reach out to him. What about your Twitters or the Book of Faces or like the Instagrams? Like, where do you want to send people after this conversation when you totally blow their mind?
Yeah, I'm everywhere on the web at Owen Video.
Is that your real last name?
You know what? That's such a great question. It should be my last name. My real last name is so hard to pronounce that it basically gets butchered everywhere that I go. You know, 2 years ago, I received Entrepreneur of the Year over here in the state of California. You know, huge honor, right? They fly me out to this whole thing. And when they announce my name, I mean, it's all the politicians in California are there, all the top business people in California, everyone that got awards, you know, was there, was getting awards. And they, you know, they go, Owen, what does it say? Hey, Jim, how do you pronounce this, Jim? And then Jim comes over and he's just like, I've never seen that name before. You know, and I'm just kind of like, you know, guys, just knock it off. Like, I walked up what should have been my grandest moment. I end up just kind of walking, you know, kind of waving them off like, guys, just stop. I received my award. It was a great honor. Rocky Chavez gave me the award. And then on the plane home, I changed all of my names to Owen Video. Because not even for me, I did it for you guys. So you would never have to pronounce that name again. You know what I mean? So
never mind.
yeah, exactly. Next question, please.
Yeah, perfect. So perfect cue. And so the next section is navigational instruments. So like today's tool. So just like wayfinders have charts, compasses, and chronometers,
yeah,
you want you to have the right tool to navigate yourself and your team to success. So what tool does one need to start creating these sales videos?
Tools. I mean, great question. First thing, as always, is you need to have a good app on your phone for editing video, right? So I'm an iPhone user. I use Videorama. We just created a whole course around Videorama and how to quickly navigate that app. So that's a great app to use. You've got to have something on your phone that allows you to sit on the train or sit in the passenger side of your car, right? So I'm married and I often just by default, I drive the car when we go play. We've got four kids. I drive the car, but what I've been more conscious of, hey, babe, can you drive so that on the 20-minute ride, I can edit this vlog on my phone and I can get that done. So we're accomplishing two things. We're getting to grandma's house, but we're also, you know, able to upload a vlog when we get home. So having that core, that go-to app on your phone, if you're using an Android, Video Chops, I think might be the name of it. Another great app to use. So you've got to have like one core app on your phone that you're using. On your computer, you got to have a core app. I would not recommend working with a free editor. You know, and they've got some of these different, we're glad that they're out there, right? Because these are entry levels to video marketing. But I recommend the videospot.net/camtasia. I can't recommend this software enough. I am very close with the company and I don't promote the products because I'm close with the company. I promote the products which made the company and I, which garnered that relationship. I just had dinner with their marketing and development team last week. And when you don't know what you're doing per se, I don't know how to edit or I don't know all the ins and outs. This is a great way to get started. It's like a regular compass versus a digital compass, right? And you got this regular compass and it's just like, where does the thing point and what's the degree, you know, versus, and I was in Boy Scouts when I was a kid or Scouts now, you know, now that it's changing, but you know, I was in, and I couldn't use a compass, you know what I mean? So when they found me, I was tired and alone and broken. No, I'm kidding. But you know, you get on your phone, you've got like a digital compass, and it just tells you what the heck to do. That's like Camtasia. Camtasia just tells you what to do. So you're able to create these great looking videos in a fraction of the time. I made my wife a professional editor in a week or so with that. Now, some other navigational tools, I would say you got to have a good webcam, right? I use the Logitech C920. In this day, I mean, it's 3 years old. It's still crystal clear. In this day and age, I'd probably get you to go the C930 or the Brio. You could actually go to livestreamgearguide.com and they have a guide there, livestreamgearguide.com, a whole PDF, 22 pages of like the best and the budget gear. So if you want to get top of the line, but if you also want to get like entry level stuff, it's all right there. So I'd get a good webcam and I would get a good microphone as well. You know, I think you guys are using the ATR 2100, the Audio Technica 2100. It's an $80 microphone, phenomenal microphone, right? And you could probably even stand back a few inches and still get great audio. I'm using the Rode Procasters, a higher end microphone, but I have to be right up on it. I have to be French kissing this microphone in order for it to work. And you know, that's why I put my wife's perfume on the mic cover right here so that every morning it's just kind of like, hello, we're here back again, aren't we? But just get a good microphone, right? Because people will watch a bad video if the audio is okay, right? But they won't watch a great video if the audio is all or if you're like way back here and talking and people can't even really hear you, they won't watch it. They'll say, I don't get this. So audio is hugely important to your methodology. And then I would say Joby tripod, right? A Joby tripod or really any tripod. Jobys have those little knuckle legs, right? Their legs are made out of like multiple knuckles, so you can attach it and put it on trees and stuff like that. You gotta have a tripod. Shaky camera is so like late 2000s. It's not even funny. Like, it's so 2012, right? it doesn't work anymore. And you've got to be prepared for that. So I would say, I didn't even count those things, but I'm just kind of like going up top of my head. You need to have those things ready to go at all times. And a Dropbox account. You got to have Dropbox. Google Drive will not do this for you. Will not, like, it's not great for media files, right? Because every file gets downloaded as a zip, and it adds extra steps. So get a Dropbox account so that you can go on your phone, you can upload your file to your Dropbox, come back in, download it on Camtasia, right? Which doesn't just do editing for you, by the way. It also can record your phone. It also can record your screen. You can pull video off the web. So I'm doing a video right now called How to Be Funny Like David Lopez. And I'm using Camtasia to grab a bunch of images from YouTube of David and then, you know, analyzing it on my channel. And all that, by the way, falls into the fair use doctrine. So it's okay to do that. And you've got, it's a great tool for those things. So that's what I would say is your starter kit.
All right.
You know, Yeah. Like, I hope people know that, like, we're dropping bombs. Like, all of this stuff is going to be in the show notes. Owen's mind is just, I knew, like, episode 2, let's do this. Here's the thing. What's funny, Owen, is I'm actually doing a similar video, but it's how to be funny like Owen video. Like, I was just trying to that. And that's so good.
It'll bring people to tears.
Yeah, there you go. But here's the thing. There's so much that you unpack there, but it's so good. It's so good. So go to the show notes, check out those tools. Owen spit out some links. I'll have the links in the show notes as well. So now we got the tools. We need to kind of move into the strategy. We need to think like a salesperson would think, or maybe a business should think around their salespeople even.
Yeah.
Like, there's a total kind of mind shift there. So we're going to move into charting the course into the show, because you know why we're not, like, going to talk about this episode is sponsored by? Because TechSmith isn't sponsoring our show yet, even though we gave them mad love for free. No, we're looking for sponsors. Really, this show is sponsored by us, Impulse Creative, and our spare time, because we have lots of that. But we should move into charting the course. And so when you think of this, when you think of video, when you think of sales, you've got the tools. Like, who should be the captain of this ship? Who needs to own this?
Right.
This process.
You know, in a company, the process, I think, should be owned by the creative, right? The content marketing manager, the social media manager, the person who's online all day watching ads and looking at different images popping up in the news feed, and the one that actually understands the LinkedIn strategy, because nobody ever talked about the video they didn't see, right? So at the end of the day, like, you know, the barrier to entry is so low. You can create a pretty unprofessional video, get great distribution on it, and start capitalizing on sales. So you need to have that strategy person involved. Here's the problem, though, is that that person should not work in a vacuum. You know, just as you have the lead pastor at a church, right, that is working towards conversion, same as all of us, you know, you want to have, right? You want to have that co-pastor, right? Or that secondary counsel that you go to, and that should be your sales manager, you know? So if you're a sales manager, sorry, you're not off the hook. You don't get to dish off the responsibility of the content to a content marketing manager and then blame marketing when your leads suck, right? We've all Amen. Been there. We know that tension exists. So the social media manager should be developing strategy and saying, okay, we're going to create, you know, a video sequence, 5 videos that walk people through the who we are, you know, the what we do and the how you can buy from us today, set an appointment today, right? That call to action video, right? And they're going to kind of come up with that, but they got to say, hey, sales manager, what the heck do we say in these videos? And your sales manager, right? That's the person that says, well, look, we have a 13-point sales process, right? We have 13 steps we walk through to make a sale. Well, duh, make those into 13 different videos, right? And some of those, then you make a whole series of your FAQs, right? And then those are just available on your website, right? I you know, so many companies don't even have the FAQs on their website, or they're written in like this text format that nobody wants to read through. And at the end of the day, everyone's looking for their question. They're not looking at your top question. They're looking for their question to be answered. Video thumbnails give you a chance to do that, right? Because you can kind of like flip through the page and just read the question and then tap on the video that's yours. You can also engage your salespeople in this process, right? So, you know, I would pick your top producing salesperson and I would say, hey, you get to be, you know, the face in our next video. Now, of course, if that person's horrible on video, you may want to rethink that strategy. You know, in a lot of cases, you might have your person who's best on camera actually do some of those things. And I would pay them separately for it. I wouldn't say, hey, you know, Jim, you're a new guy, but we're going to put, you're so great with your personality, we're going to put you on camera. Like, you need to pay him a little bit extra for that because you're taking time away from him and making sales and that sort of thing. At the end of the day, you know, you get those five videos that were co-produced by the sales manager and the social media manager. And then guess what, sales manager? After you've sort of like consulted on what to say in those videos, then you get to back off and let the social media person do their thing. And if the leads that come in from that, you know, are not great, then that gives you, sales manager, a chance to refine and develop your message for an online audience, right? This is a different audience than your postcard audience. It's a different audience than your door knocking audience. It's a different audience than your telemarketing audience. And so you got to be ready for that. Be ready to adjust, to shift, and to get a new batch of videos out the next quarter and do it again.
Boom. All right. So I got some follow-up on that is, so what do you think the historical narrative that most companies have around these sales videos? Are they doing them? Are they scared to do them? Like, what's the big thing that is?
Yeah, I think they're scared to do them. I think they have no idea what to do. And then of course they, you know, there's this kind of like, well, who do we blame if it all goes down? Right. Sure. And those are co-related. The idea is this, is like, how can you teach your salespeople to grab their nuggets and ask the big closing questions, right? Like when I was in sales, like hardcore sales, the biggest question I struggled with was, what did you like best about what you just heard? I always felt like that was such a sales question. And I still struggle with it to this day, even though it's part of my sales questioning, right? It's like when we go through our pitch, we do ask that question. You can't expect your salespeople to grab their nuggets and go the distance if you're not going to grab yours and go the distance, right? You have got to put yourself out there and say, we're going to try video. We know it's working. We only have so much more time with these postcards, with telemarketing, right? That is a sinking ship. And you've only got so much time on that before you're going to look around and go, oh my gosh, this is illegal now. This is illegal now. Or the response from this is so low, right, that it's not worth pursuing. Right. You know, we're doing video for a company right now, Fortune 1000 company, that has street teams. They have ground teams, and they're knocking on doors, and they're doing the whole, you know, kind of like sign up for our service thing. We were able to replace them in, 6 months of producing video. So think about the power in that. Yeah, think about the power in no longer needing some third-party street team to knock on doors for you, right? But you're not going to get to that right out of the gates, right? You're going to have to, you know, make a couple videos that tank. Learn from that and move on. There's always this idea of like, oh, and we're going to hire you and we're going to buy some rubber bands to wrap our fat stacks of cash, right? And it's like, all right, we'll first get some tissues because the first 90 days are going to bring you to tears. Like, we're going to find out that your message that you were using in 1991 does not work online. We're going to find out that your old beat up logo doesn't resonate with any millennials. And you know, we have to go through that, right? It's the cycle of nations, right? Is a nation goes from like enslaved to revival to free to opulent to, you know, and there's a cycle of nations. It's like the cycle of your company on advertising, right? You have to kind of go through the pain before you can experience the joy of what video marketing can do. And if you're doing it wisely, and if you're working with a consultant like me, you can get through that in about 60 to 90 days, but you have to go through it.
First of all, boom sauce, because there's so much there. I like to talk about fat stacks of cash. Also, you know, if you're not part of the solution or part of the problem, so yes, you can be replaced by video, but if you're one of the OGs and you're ready to do some video, then you're going to be sticking around. Also, the last little nugget there is, whenever I grab my nuggets, my wife tells me to knock it off. But probably a different, that's probably a different story. Now, Owen, what I want you to do is imagine that you're at sea and it's just glass, right? Like it's just so smooth and it's just perfection. You see the sunset out in the distance and you realize as a company, that's where I need to go.
Yeah.
So we're talking about there's no obstructions, there's no tidal waves, tsunamis, things like that. When we think that way, where is it that these companies who historically are like, oh, what do you mean our Comic Sans and Papyrus logo bait, like thing won't work? Like where do they want to sail to? Talk to us about that.
You know what? Your goal is scalable Facebook ads. That is your goal. You are getting to a place where you're generating a lead for $3 or $20. I don't know. Like every company is different. It all comes down to what your sales process is. But you want to be in a place where, you know, you're in a place where you're able to send, you know, $1,000 of traffic to a landing page and you're able to output from that $3,000 to $5,000 in sales or whatever. You know, some people are like, those numbers are horrible. I'm turning this off. Well, you know, like use your imagination, brah. You know what I mean? Like go with me here. I'm just throwing out numbers. But you want to be at a place where your investment or your output is 3 to 5 times out of your investment, right? So now you're in a place, right? You're in Jerusalem, as we say. You're in the Mecca. You are in where everybody wants to go. You know, if you spend $100 on ads, you're going to get $300 in sales, right? At a minimum. So you're in a place of elite. Like you're in the Facebook marketing elite, and that allows you to what? Dump more money into your Facebook ads and then get more of an output. That's where you want to go. So you should be looking at your landing page conversion for your lead conversion. How many leads are you getting? And then you're looking at, okay, do you have a tripwire, right? Do you have a secondary page there that says, hey, since you got our free offer, we thought maybe you'd be interested in our $17 offer, right? Low cost, low barrier to entry product. They could either say yes or no, right? If they say yes, you say, great. Hey, since you liked our low cost offer, would you like to meet with a sales representative who can walk you through the process of getting into this fine vehicle, or, you know, who can, like with realtors, what we do is cup of coffee. Would you like to sit down with a realtor from our team that will buy you a cup of coffee and get to know everything that you're looking for and begin a customized home search for you in this area, right? So, you know, in that realtor example, the free offer might be like a guide to the top schools in your area, right? So download our guide to the top schools in the area. The next is maybe like a packet of information. It's like $7, right? And it's all the homes, all this, and you're gonna ship it to, you're gonna mail it to them, almost like a MLS on paper, right? And you're gonna mail it to them. Why are you doing that? Because if they're willing to pull out their cash, right? If they're willing to pull out their wallet for a $7, a $17 item, they're already a customer. Now all you're doing is you're upgrading a customer, and we all know the cost to upgrade a customer is far less than the cost to acquire a new one. So now you've got somebody who's already spent money with you. They're already in the know and trust cycle, and to get them to like you, you offer them that free cup of coffee. And so that's like a tripwire funnel. And that will work with just about anything to get them moving. But that's where you're trying to go. And so you want to crank ads to your free lead magnet to get more people setting that appointment or doing that call with you. And there's no gimmicks to it, right? It's not like, hey, we went to a timeshare presentation for the Disneyland tickets. Like that's why we went. 90 minutes, my foot, right? It's more like 90 days we were there. You know what I mean? 45 of those days were just writing no contract. You know, no. You offer gimmicks, people are going to sign up for the gimmicks. Don't offer the gimmicks, right? Just tell them like, look, I'm going to help you find the home of your dreams. Right? I'm going to help you find the car of your dreams. I'm going to help you develop a software, get a software that's going to make you more sales. And we don't want to waste our time with tire kickers. So I'll tell you what, get this free offer first. If you like it, let's set an appointment.
That was a whole lot of information we got to unpack.
Good luck with that.
Yeah. So that'll be fun. But so when we talk about like, let's give like 2 to 3 things companies can execute today, this moment to get started with these things.
So the first thing is write out 25 titles that you could turn into videos. This is going to become like your dream board, right? And dream board is maybe the wrong word. It's your game plan, right? This is your action plan. So 25 video titles. Now, it's really easy to do. Start with who, what, why, where, when, and how. Start with those, and you'll come up with way more than 25, right? You could also just go right to your sales process. What is your 13-point sales process? Maybe it's like company history, product history. You know, I used to sell in-home vinyl windows. So maybe there's a, like a UPVC versus PVC, right? Maybe there's like sort of like Simonton versus Milgard, right? And some of those types of videos that you could be doing, but write out a full title, right? A lot of what I see a lot of business people doing is they'll write out a title that's like, you know, talk about quality. And that's what's on their Excel spreadsheet. It's like, well, what are we talking about here, pal? The quality of your employees, the quality of your company, the quality of your product, quality of your customer service, right? Let's get into that, right? So take that, okay, quality, products, shipping, right? And you're just kind of writing down these categories, right? Go farther than that, right? Like specific. Who, what, why, where, when, and how, right? Who is Impulse Creative, right? Who is George B. Thomas, right? What? What does Impulse Creative do? What does, why? Why do people love Impulse Creative? Why do people need marketing, right? Get that whole question out. How to get more sales from video. How to find the home of your dreams. How to pick a software lead generation company, right? These really expand on those titles. So number one is get those titles written out. Number two, you have to come up with like a solid intro and a solid outro. Now, we teach a whole like 6 to 10 point pitch model, right? Which starts with your hook, and then it goes into your bumper, and then your intro, and then your subscribe call value statement, right? There's all these different things. But at the end of the day, you need two major points. You need that intro statement that says like, here's who we are and here's what we do. Hey, if you're just logging in, we're Impulse Creative and we help companies do X, Y, Z. If you're into that kind of thing, subscribe to the channel, right? And you should memorize that and you should have that said the same way every time across all the different people that are in your videos. And then the end of the video, you should have a closing statement. And remember to subscribe because we're Impulse Creative, where we help you do X, we help you do Y, and we do it 3 times a week on YouTube, Facebook, and LinkedIn. So don't forget to share this video with a friend, right? And you're going to say that the same way every single time. So get those two bumper statements together, right? And then, you know, you've got an opening and a closing for all of your videos. One of the biggest questions we get is, how do I start the video, right? And that's how you start it. You just start it with that bumper statement and then you start talking, right? And you end it with that bumper statement and then you stop talking, right? And that gives you the bookends. There's lots of stuff in the middle that we can talk about. And if you go to thevideospot.net, a little pop-up will pop up. Get that book because it'll walk you through like our whole 6-point process for business owners. The last thing is this, is think about your thumbnails, right? The thumbnail is the visual representation of the video online. Now on Facebook, Your thumbnail is not as important because videos autoplay. So you'll only see the thumbnail for a split second before that video starts to play. But you will see it much longer, right? When you're watching a video on Facebook, there's another video underneath it that's about ready to play. That's the thumbnail you're looking at. And then as soon as you – and it's amazing. The studies have been done how much attention is given to that bottom. People know what's coming up. They see like this pink color, a starburst, and an old lady face, and they're kind of going, huh, I wonder what that is. So when it pops up, they're already interested in watching it, right? So your thumbnails do matter on Facebook, but they're not as prevalent. On YouTube, the whole platform is thumbnails. You pick a thumbnail. In fact, on YouTube, a view is 30 seconds or a user-generated action, meaning they clicked on a thumbnail. Right? So your thumbnail is what's going to win the click, right? My good buddy Brian G. Johnson wrote a book on YouTube. Chapter 4 is called Win the Click. I gave him that name and he used it in his book. You have to win the click. Someone's going to type for something like SaaS software, right? Or SaaS lead generation tool or something like that. And they're going to see 10 thumbnails. They're going to have to pick one. You have to win that click by creating a thumbnail that's professional, engaging, and maybe a little bit bold, right? Stands out just a tad, right? And you've got to figure out, you know, we talk about come up with your title and then come up with your thumbnail immediately before you even write the video, right? Because those are the two things that are going to matter. In fact, I wrote a video last night. As soon as I was done, I got the thumbnail to my graphic designer with what we're trying to accomplish and that. So I haven't even filmed the video yet, but the thumbnail is already in the works because we may have to do 2 or 3 revisions of it.
Owen, here's the thing. I got to stop for 1 second because when Remington and I were explaining that we were going to have a podcast that was a little bit different and we're going to do an episode, which was an interview. And then the following episode was going to be a breakdown of what they heard in that episode. We kind of got this thing like, huh, that sounds interesting. I don't know why you do that. Understand why we're doing that?
Yeah.
I just throw that out there. Like, there's so much that we haven't even been able to unpack that the whole next episode, you guys have to tune in because we are going to break down the things that Owen is talking about. Here's another thing. You want to get the show notes. I mentioned it earlier. I'm going to mention it again. And we're going to use some of the things that Owen is talking about for our newsletter. You want to go to wayfindinggrowth.com, sign up for that newsletter so we can skirt you over some information that's going to help change your life. You know who else is changing lives, guys, is the folks in our Captain Killing It section. And that is some folks that you know really well, Owen. We're going to talk about Marcus Walter and Carlos Z from Kiwi Real Estate.
Yeah.
Why don't you explain to the Wayfinding Growth audience how they have left the dock of mediocrity and been killing it on the socials?
Yeah. I mean, okay. So Marcus and Kiwi is what we call them, right? Kiwi on the coast. Kiwi and Carlos are just doing such a great job with video. Here's a couple of guys who are kind of like, you know, lead the way and we'll just do whatever you ask us to do. So their story is this, is that they hired a videographer to go out to their place of business and shoot a whole bunch of B-roll, right? So it wasn't like, oh, we're going to shoot 10 videos, right? This is what a lot of people say is, oh, I'm going to shoot 10 videos today. No. Just shoot a crap load of B-roll. Get a shot of you shaking hands with people, high-fiving babies, right? And picking up a cup of coffee. We got a shot of Kiwi sort of like looking out over the beach and then putting his glasses on, right? And what we did, that was a 7-second shot. We turned that into a 5-second shot, made it slow-mo, and then at the end it fades out and it says Kiwi Real Estate. Right. And that's their Facebook ad. Isn't that crazy? Right. So shoot a bunch of B-roll. Right. So you got all this B-roll. Then what we did is we turned that B-roll into a sizzle reel. Right. And we left a couple of spots open for putting in customized sections for our customers. Right. Putting in sections where they could see their house and they could see sort of their, you know, their thing in there. Well, Kiwi and Carlos made that video, sent it to a client, and closed a $5 million listing. And a listing, for those of you not in real estate, that is money in the bank. That means when that house sells, 3-6% go directly to the agency. That all came from, the customer was so impressed with that video, right? That they were like, you know what? You're my real estate company. So they crushed it. They're working hard at it. They're doing a live stream now on Facebook. This is a company that gets it. They understand what needs to get done, and they're doing it. They're not just blaming each other in the office. Why isn't the video done? Why isn't the editing done? You know, they're just getting it done, and they're having a blast doing it.
Awesome. Thank you so much for that. So the next section is the Bermuda Triangle. So, you know, we're going to lead into some questions here, but so what makes this impossible for companies? Like, what is like this wall that they just can't get past, or some companies just can't get past?
The legal team, you know, the old guy who's been there for 20 years, that's slowing up the show. You know what I mean? Like, it's time to retire him, guys. Like, okay. So he built the company in the 80s, right? I get it. Right. He runs the meetings now and everyone falls asleep. Why? Cause he's still doing freaking meetings. Right? Like, how many of you guys have been to meetings that could have been an email, right? It's time to transition those people out, right? Put them in charge of something new, like the soda machines, right? Hey, Bill, appreciate all your effort in the 90s. We're now giving you the break room. That's your responsibility. But this new younger guy is going to take over the video marketing. Now, so I was in corporate America for a while, and these were the guys that always demoted me. These were the guys, you know, like, I worked at a radio station, second biggest radio network in the country. And I came in there and I introduced these new ideas for how we could get new sales. Well, after a while, they fired me and then immediately started implementing those things I started teaching to them. So it was very interesting to me to be at Social Media Marketing World where I was speaking, and there's a guy in the audience from that radio network listening to me speak on how to use video. I mean, insane, right? Insane. Like the same company that fired me is now watching me speak and going like, how can you help us? So here's the deal. There's a guy, there's a gal at your office who is always saying no. And you've got to work around that person, right? Oh, that'll never work. Our customers, they like, right? It's that, what was the guy from Dennis the Menace, right? The older guy, I forget his name, that was always like messing with Dennis. You've got to bypass that guy. You have got to go make the videos. Make them. Get them done in your house. If you're a salesperson, get those videos done and use them, right? Especially if you're 1099. You don't need your company's approval to do this. Make the videos. Get them out there. Show the proof, right? And don't let older people, and I'm not all older people, but that guy, that roadblock, that Bermuda Triangle, bypass them, right? Be innovative. Take a risk. And get into that new space of marketing. Because again, you're going to have to go through that 3-month, you know, sort of like trial and error phase. You need to get through that as fast as possible. And there's always going to be somebody who's threatened by new creativity and innovation. You have to bypass that person.
So thank you for that. So bottom line on that is you're looking out for the Mr. Wilsons of
yes.
the world, which is the guy from Dennis the Menace. I'm just beautiful. Throwing that out there.
Did you have to look that up?
Maybe. Maybe not. Hey, Google is my friend, people. So here's the next question. You have these people who try, right? They want to do this. They believe everything we're throwing down. For those who try, why do you see historically with the folks that you work with that they end up failing where others don't fail?
You know, the failure happens in the distribution, right? So you work on one video 18 times, and by the time you get it out there, it's outdated and you hate it, right? That's the big thing, right? Get the video done. Get it out. My good friend Jeff Weiss over at The Weiss Life, he runs a family vlog. He says, you know, however much footage you have, you should never spend more than double that time editing, right? So if you've got 5 minutes of footage, that should be, you know, more of like a 10 minute edit. Right? You're not taking a ton of time. You're clipping out the end. You're clipping out the ums and ohs, and then you're adding your branding and you're done. Right? And you've got to remember that, you know, you're making video to get out there, to get response, to get numbers, and you're looking at what people are responding to. What we do is we work on, and my wife is going through this too. Like we're launching a family vlog and she's been editing one piece for like 3 weeks. Is the music right? Is the text right? And I was like, you know what? None of it's right. That's the thing, is it just needs to get up, right? It just needs to go on the web. Look, at the end of the day, you're selling medical supplies, right? You've got doctors, you've got clients that need these supplies. All they want to know is that you got them and you can meet with them. They're not interested in the colors and the lights and oh, you know, are you using iambic pentameter? And is your music, you know, diegetic or non-diegetic, right? These are filmmaking terms. No one cares. You know,
sure.
No one cares. Get up there, do the video, get it out there, judge your results, make your next one better. We never, ever go back. We always move towards the future. You know, so once the video is shot and edited, it's done. We're done. Get it on the web, move forward. And I've got some crap on the web, guys. I have got some big stinky piles of crap on the web, believe me. And I'm embarrassed by them. And it's like, oh, like, okay, so I got a whole crew. I recruited actors. We had a whole film production going. We got some guy to donate his office for the day. We were in the office all day shooting what I called Rudolph the Red-Nosed Marketer. And when I launched that like 2 years ago, and I thought this was going to be like my big breakthrough piece. I thought it was going to take over the Christmas season. Not even my friends replied to the video. Didn't even get like the, hey, great attempt, right? Didn't even get that. From it. And it was embarrassing. It was embarrassing for the actors because I told them we were going to get 10,000 views, but we decided not even to boost it. You know, I just kind of let it die on the vine and never mention it again. And I learned. Oh, yeah. Yeah, exactly. Right. I'm ruined. You know, we learn from it. We move on. And I go, you know, for me, the lesson was this longer form narrative was not my strength. So I would put that on the back burner until a later time. And we still haven't picked it up again. We're still doing more like newsy updates, fast-paced, kind of funny things. And that's what people want to see from us.
what is your last one thing that everyone needs to remember before we start tying this up?
You know, I think just to reinforce what I just said, shoot it and upload it. That's it. Shoot it and upload it, right? It's going to suck. You're going to hate it. And you know, that's part of life. You know, you just have to get over that, right? Like, it's never going to be perfect to you, sure. Right? So just get it up and get it done. You will be surprised. My best performing video up until a certain time, like when I launched my company in a dirty Walmart shirt, I had slept in that shirt. I was in my room at 2 a.m. doing website design strategy. And I decided, like, you know what? I don't ever want to have to like explain this again. So I wrote it on the whiteboard and I filmed it. Added my bumper and I uploaded it. I came back to YouTube. I had 6,000 subscribers. People were calling me, asking them to build their websites for them. That launched my company. And I did it on accident, right? People ask me, how'd you build your YouTube channel? I'm like, accidentally, can I come speak at your conference? You know, the whole thing is this, is shoot it and get it up there. Because, you know, do one video a week and just shoot it and get it up there and see what happens. Notice the ones that perform and do more of those. Any video you make today, you can remake in 3 months. Sure. Right? So don't wait to do it. Do it now. Get it out. Do it again in 3 months.
100%. Awesome. Thank you so much.
So Owen, if people want to reach out to you, if they want to connect, if they want to learn more of these nuggets that they can grab hold of, if they want to set sail and get a compass to where they want to go, where would you want to send them?
TheVideoSpot.net. And check out our online courses, right? We have a couple different levels there. You can grab an a la carte course, right? We teach Facebook ads in a course. We teach how to make square videos in a course. We've got a course on live streaming and a YouTube launching for business. You can buy one course or, you know, for $37, you can get a membership and get access to all of my courses. And as long as you're a paying member, you got access to the course. Use them for your company. Use them for your own business. Go to thevideospot.net and just explore what we have in what we call the BizTube Academy. Lots of great training there. And if you want to step it up, if you really want to get some one-to-one time with someone like me, then fill out our form and let's set an appointment. I'd love to see how I could help.
Absolutely. Look, folks, if you're anything like me, you can't wait till next week's episode where we break all of this down. Owen has been a boss. It's been incredibly crazy. I think I actually might need to re-navigate myself before I move on with the rest of the day. Look, if you're listening on iTunes, make sure you go over and leave a rating and review. We'd like to hear what you think of the show and where you would like to learn things for your business. If you're watching this on YouTube, then yo, hit that subscribe, hit the bell for instant notifications. And this is, of course, Remington Bag, George B. Thomas from Impulse Creative and Wayfinding Growth saying, see you next week.